Here's the season to be jolly, folks. It's your host, Donald Wanda. Welcome back to Tower Media. I'm recording this, or if you're watching this video right now, it's December 2014. It's the week of Christmas. And I want to give you guys two Christmas recommendations this week I think you should really check out. Now, they're both animated movies. Well, they're both animated features. One's an anime series and one is an animated movie. We're going to start with the anime series. So people, I'm going to be the gift that keeps on giving. Check this out.
Tyro Media.
All right, people, let's start things off by talking about the underrated series called Zeta Pain. Zeta Pain is a 2006 animated sci-fi mecha series made by Studio Sunrise, and unfortunately, it was distributed in the West to the US and, you know, the Western countries by Bandai Entertainment. Bandai Entertainment actually closed down, so this anime is very, very hard to come by, guys. The DVD set sell for a shitload of money. I mean, it's ridiculous. Now, the good news is, Sentai Filmworks recently bought the license to Zeta Pain, but they said they want to wait until the 10-year anniversary, which will be 2016, before they do something with it. Now, whether that's going to be a complete reboot or reanimated series, or they're just going to re-release the original series, I don't know. It's been very hush-hush. But regardless, you guys should check out Zeta Pain. And Zeta Pain is one of those animes that the name kind of threw me off. Zeta Pain sounds like Zeta Pain, Mega Hurt, Ultra Feels. What kind of name is Zeta Pain? I mean, I know there's a lot of worse animes with a lot of worse names. I'm going to try to find one and put one on the screen, but Zeta Pain doesn't sound very inspired. But when you watch the anime, you obviously find out what it's about. But enough of that, let's talk about what Zeta Pain is about. Zeta Pain is an anime series. Honestly, it's one of those shows that there's more than meets the eye. It's about a young boy named Kyo. It's set in high school, here we go again, very generic. High school anime boy is trying to get people in his swim team, in his swim class. He's trying to get more students to join his swim team. And one day he comes across this girl jumping off one of those diving boards on a swimming pool he's never seen before. He gets entangled with this girl, and I'm not going to get into spoilers, but through a series of events, he ends up piloting a virtual reality mecha game. And in this virtual reality mecha game, he's fighting these monsters with this girl. And through this virtual reality mecha game, he finds out things about his real life that shatter his whole perception of reality and stuff like that. It's one of those ones where he finds out more about his own life through this game. It's, you know, again, I'm being very vague because I don't want to ruin it. This story has a lot of good twists that are not corny, that are not... You've seen them in other stories before, but it's just done so well. Zeta Pain's story is very intriguing. It deals with themes of existentialism, of artificial intelligence versus humanity, you know, artificial versus natural, so many themes about consciousness and stuff, but it doesn't beat you over the head with it. It's not boring, it's very engrossing, and the characters develop with the story. As these plot twists come through with the story, the characters have to go with the story. It's kind of hand in hand. This story progresses very naturally. And although it's a mecha, it deals with more sci-fi elements than mecha. And it just works, man. This story just works so well. And it's, you know, it was done in 2006. It's kind of old, but the concept is just fresh. The ideas are not new, but the way it's all melded together is fresh. With anime, you can't come up with an original story now. Everyone feeds off each other. You'll see bits and pieces of different stories in the Zeta Pain, but the execution is great. That's what makes Zeta Pain so damn good. Now, let me talk about some of the other aspects. The sound is really great, man. If you check out the opening and closing themes on YouTube, you just watch the themes. The music is beautiful. It really is. The opening, I love the opening. I love the ending theme. It's very mellow, very relaxing. Yeah. But it's just good. The overall theme of the music with the background in the actual anime is good as well. The English dub is very good. Whether it was Bandai or another studio dubbing company that did it, I watched the dub. I have no problems recommending the dub. And over the holiday season, if you want to sit back and watch it in English, I don't think you'll be disappointed. Unfortunately, all is not good. Where Zega Pain falters is the animation. Now, I know it was made in 2006, and in 2014 we're seeing all this gorgeous anime from Rage of the Bahamut and Parasite and all this other stuff. The animation, even for 2006, is not very inspired. It just looks very generic. When you see the anime, when you see the box art of this anime, it just looks like Mecha Title 79. It just looks like you've seen this before. It looks like one of those Gundam clones. The mecha designs are just meh. The action is meh. The character designs are meh. But if you guys know me, I never let animation be the driving force for my entertainment. I'm telling you that the animation on the whole is meh, but it's not god awful. It's watchable. It's very, very watchable. But it's the thing that kind of lets the whole package down. But getting back to the story is executed so well that the animation is good enough. The story carries animation. The story carries everything in this show. And to make matters even better, it has a good ending. It has a very good resolution. So when you look back on this anime on a whole, it's a great package. Zega Pain is a good all-arounder. It's one of those shows that has slipped through the cracks. It's a great all-arounder. You pick it up now, you'll say to yourself, that was a damn good show. And I don't know why it hasn't got the praise it deserves, all the awareness it deserves. This holiday season, treat yourself to Zega Pain. Or whenever you're watching this, treat yourself to an anime that slipped through the cracks, that was recommended to me by other people. And I have to say, I'm really glad, because this was a very enjoyable watch. You like mecha anime, watch Zega Pain. You'll be pleasantly surprised. It's actually more sci-fi than mecha. The sci-fi concepts are explored more than the mecha. But the combination of the two is actually really good. So I'm going to leave it at that. My rating for Zega Pain is going to be it's a low first class. The animation lets it down, but the package on the whole is still very good. I'll be happy when they redistribute this. I don't know if I guess it wouldn't hurt to reanimate the show, but I think no, this original run is fine. Right now, if you want to watch it, you're probably going to have to stream it illegally, because Jesus Christ, have you seen how much these box sets are right now? And I don't know why, in the meantime, these guys haven't just put it out digitally so you can pay to rent it on Netflix or whatever. But as far as I can see, you just can't find it to stream by any legal means. So, you know, I don't want to condone piracy, but I think you should check it out to get the word of mouth out there, to promote it. And then when the legal stream comes out, buy these guys, you know, buy it, buy it, buy it. I know I will, but I'm just promoting the show right now. Zega Pain, low first class. Check it out. I hope you enjoy, guys. So on that note, leave a comment down below. If you've seen Zega Pain, let me know. If you haven't, you've got to watch it. Let me know what you think about it after you watch it, man. I'm interested. Whether you loved it, whether you hated it, I don't mind, guys. I just like to interact with y'all. So let's leave it there, guys. Thanks for watching another episode of Tower Media. I've got another animated title to check out, for you guys to check out this week. Another one that's under the radar. I'm going to tell you what it is right now. Check out the next episode, guys. And until then, enjoy your week of Xmas. And I'll see you on the next video, people. Take care. Peace out.